Hey, what's happening, Got Gamers? It's Luke, and I'm here with Ray, the producer for DuckTales Remastered.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm pretty excited.
Yeah, as you can tell, my voice is a little trashed. PAX East has been quite a party.
Oh, PAX East is insane. We have had so many people here compared to last year, but it's growing into its own entity, it seems.
Yeah, absolutely, and I love the fact that it's actually, unlike some other consumer-oriented shows, this is purely games.
Yep.
Games of all kinds.
Yeah, we even have board games.
Yeah, it's huge out there. Huge. Tabletop, card games, it's all there.
So what can you tell us about DuckTales Remastered?
So, I'm sure you guys have seen the trailer. We're basically bringing DuckTales back. What we've done is, or what WayForward has done, we're working with WayForward, who you might know from the from Double Dragon recently. They did Blood Rain, Boy and His Blob. So these guys really know their 2D platforming type of games. Basically what they've done is they've taken the old DuckTales game, kind of used it as their map, their guide, and reconstructed that using their WayForward engine. And we've taken all the character animation. These are all purely hand-drawn individually. It's like we're not swapping any kind of hands or feet or anything. This is literally, it starts off like drawing 101, sticks and balls, animated that, you lay on the character. It's really just like how Disney does their stuff. And then from there on, we are putting it inserted into the game. About 70% of what you're going to see is going to be laid out almost exactly like you remember it from the NES days. And about 30% of that is going to be like new retuning, new repathing a little bit. A new tutorial level, intro level, a lot like Mega Man X, where you kind of learn how to play the game initially and you get a little bit of the story.
And then you go
right into a hub world, which is kind of new for DuckTales. We have you can swim in the vault now. We got a cool gallery, and there's also a new end level. So instead of having to go through like Transylvania multiple times like you did in the original game,
So this is actually
a totally new level right before you get to Count Dracula Duck.
Yeah, what I've seen from the game so far, the art style is more than just a tribute of the original NES 8-bit. It's also a tribute of the old cartoon show, which is amazing.
Yeah, so we've been working really closely with Disney, and Disney's been really working really close with us to make sure that, all the characters look absolutely right. I mean, these guys will go through with a fine-tooth comb and make sure that, like, that, you know, this number on the Beagle Boy is not, that's not the official number he's got. You got to use this one. So if you notice, Scrooge is wearing his blue outfit, like that's from the actual cartoon. In the NES version, he had his red coat. Yeah, so for this one, we're actually using the cartoon look. And actually, if you pay close attention, you'll notice a lot of the assets, like what we're showing Transylvania here, the background is more modeled after a scene out of the cartoon as opposed to out of the NES version. And like the bat is... actually looks nothing like the bat from the game. It looks like a bat from a particular episode of DuckTales. The guys at WayForward are intensely dedicated to DuckTales, the IP, and then DuckTales, the game. They're just huge fans of it.
Yeah, from what I've seen of the game too, all the moves are back, like the cane and everything else. Can we expect any additional characters or even more cameos from people like Gizmo Duck and such?
So, Gizmo Duck is definitely going to be there. That means Fenton will be there. So will Gyro, and the old enemies, Glomgold, the Beagle Boys. So it's actually going to be the same characters you remember from the NES game, because we didn't want to toy with the actual canon of what was going on. All what we really did was expand upon the compact story that was in the NES version. So you're going to kind of get a better sense of why Scrooge and Glomgold are going after all these items. And actually, I don't remember exactly how it was in the original version, but there's going to be kind of like a little twist, and I think, well, you know, that's like the one secret we're going to keep, but I think everything else I can tell you.
Gizmo Duck kind of just showed up, and he blew something up, and then he just disappeared.
Yeah, so he's actually going to have, he'll play like a bigger role in this one. So for instance, he's still only in the moon base, but in the original game, like, you went onto the UFO to find like a remote control, which basically was to call Gizmo Duck in from the blow up a door. So in this version, on the introduction of the game, of the level, Fenton will be kidnapped by the UFO. That's why you're going on the UFO. So you go out to free Fenton, find the three pieces of his Gizmo Duck suit, not the remote control. And then when you have all those pieces, you go to Fenton and he puts it on. Then he escorts you and blows up everybody on the way to the door, and then he blows it up.
That is awesome.
So yeah, I mean, it's not like the NES version it just they didn't have the assets and the resources to really tell you that part of the story. So the guys at Wayfair and Disney really came up with a cool like explanation of why you're doing what you're doing, and it fit better than a remote control.
Since this game is also heading to the Wii U, can you tell us any specific features that'll be on that system?
So we're gonna go ahead and use the Wii U as, you know, as best we can. It's gonna have the remote play feature, so you can just play it on the screen. But if you're playing on, you know, your normal TV screen, what's new to the game is a map. So for easy and medium modes, I believe hard, there'll be varying degrees of map usage. But instead of having to go in the pause menu like you do on the other consoles, on the Wii U, the map will just be on the small screen.
Okay, so just the map and also off TV play.
Yeah.
What about Miiverse?
There's no Miiverse points.
Aw, that's too bad.
Yeah.
So can we expect any others like special things other than the traditional levels?
So I had briefly mentioned the vault, which, you know, it seems like a kind of a minor thing. So basically in a new hub world, you can access his money bin vault, which, you know, as we all know from the cartoon, he likes to swim in, and you can actually do that in the game. And it really seems like a small thing, and to be honest, I thought it'd be like one of these things we can gloss over, but it's kind of a nice. But for people like you and I that, you know, grew up watching DuckTales and really have a soft spot for it, that action apparently like really resonates with everybody. So like when we did focus tests with people, they actually really liked jumping in there and just swimming around. But it does have a cool little game plan, because as you collect more coins throughout the game, or gems, your vault will fill up. And it'll reach a max, of course. So instead of having to dive and go all the way down to the bottom, you kind of dive and just go a little bit. But, you know, you have a money bin full of gold and money.
Yeah, because Scrooge likes his money dips.
He does. There's actually a pretty cool... In the intro level, there's a cool line when one of his nephews is kidnapped, but instead of him going, "Oh no, you got Huey," he's like, "Me money," and I think it's Huey's all like, "Oh, what about me, Uncle Scrooge?" And he's like, "Yeah, I'll get you too." Yeah, I mean, it's still the same Scrooge, but he's still a lovable guy. I mean, I think one of his characteristics is that even though he's like this huge, richly, and, you know, kind of a greedy guy, family is like such an important thing to him, and I think that's always been a recurring theme in DuckTales, and that's why people have kind of like really liked it, despite that this guy is, for all intents and purposes, I mean, he's a Scrooge.
Yeah, you guys have done an amazing job, even getting most of the original voice talent back, which is incredible.
Yeah, that was a huge thanks to Disney, and they really wanted to make the game as authentic as it could be, and adding the voices. And I know you haven't had a chance to really hear the voices and play the game, but once you get that chance to hear it, it's really gonna round out the whole experience, and it's gonna be like playing a Saturday morning cartoon, because it animates great and it sounds great, and the music really boosts all that as well.
Yeah, it sounds amazing. When can we expect DuckTales Remastered to release?
It's coming out later this year in the summer. And for all major consoles, so for PSN, XBLA, and Wii U eShop.
Well, thank you very much, Ray. I appreciate it. DuckTales looks awesome. Thank you so much.